Hey guys, Becky here with Design Bundles, and I'm super excited to have you join me today because we have a really awesome tutorial to show you all the wonderful things you can do with the new Cricut Design Space Offset tool. So this is definitely one you don't want to miss.
All right, guys, so here we are in Cricut Design Space, and I'm so incredibly excited to share all these ideas with you because the offset feature is one that I've always felt the Cricut Design Space was lacking. And of course, you know, we have a few workaround videos, but this is a really big game changer, and this is going to make it so much easier for you to create offsets, obviously. So the first thing I want to tell you is your offset feature is located right up here in the top toolbar, your top toolbar. If you do not see it, then you want to come into your menu, the three lines over here on the left-hand side, and choose settings. All right, now scroll down to the bottom and make sure that your canvas style is set to new. If it's set to classic, then you're not going to have that offset feature, so make sure it's set to new and hit done. Also, this was part of an update that happened. So if your Cricut Design Space has not updated recently, then you may want to check into that. But I do know that as soon as they launched it, as soon as they pushed it out, the very next time I launched Cricut Design Space on my computer, then it prompted me, it did an update, and automatically offset was there. So super, super exciting, like I said. Now, there are going to be some thinking outside the box ideas for you today, but don't worry because we're gonna cover all the basics also, but then hopefully share a few of those extra ideas with you. Now, most commonly, I feel like offsets are used for creating a border around either a set of text or a design. I'm going to go ahead and use some text here for an example. Now, of course, this is just very, very basic. I'm just using offset as an example. And then let's go ahead and correct our placement here. We're going to ungroup these, and it's just mainly the E and the T. Okay, so none of that is important to the offset, but I just could not proceed without doing the offset. Now, we're just going to, let me move this down. I want you guys to see it really well. We're going to open the offset panel here, and did you see how I have now a thin blue line around the entire design? So I can control the thickness or the thinness of the design by using this scale here. Now, the lower that I go on the scale, it actually turns into an internal offset. So something to keep in mind, because that may not be what you want, but if you're trying to thin it out and all of a sudden it disappears, usually that's what's happened. I typically stick around between a 0.05 and a 0.1. Those seem to be pretty good offsets. Your distance a lot of times will depend on the size of the project that you're doing. And that probably doesn't make a whole lot of sense, but I do try to make sure that my offsets, that I add those after I size my design, because a 0.1 offset may be fine for a larger design, but if I'm going to make it smaller, all of a sudden that offset may be too small. So just something to keep in mind. I can also choose if I want rounded corners or square corners. Now, this is a rounded text, so you're not going to see a big difference, but typically I stick with rounded corners unless I need to, unless it's a square design. So let's just hit apply. Now that usually adds a pretty neat little feature. Let's switch this to a new color. There we go. So isn't that cute? So this allows me to be able to layer vinyl on top of vinyl if I really want it to pop. This is very common for me if I'm wanting to use pattern heat transfer vinyl, or really just any pattern. I just happen to use more heat transfer vinyl, but let me just show you what it looks like with the pattern. Okay, and what this does, especially if you are setting it against a light color, it really gives your design definition. So I think when most people think of an offset, this is what you're thinking of, is the ability to just create that border and to be able to cut it and layer it. All right, so let's move on to use number two for an offset. We're gonna group this together. We're not gonna get rid of it yet. We're just gonna move it off to the side. But I'm going to type out some text here. Now, this is not, it's not strictly necessary. When I say necessary, I just mean it's not necessarily for you to type this out. This one really is an example. So what I want to show you is sometimes, especially when you're cutting small objects, when you're using a thin font, then that can really cause a lot of problems with your cutting. It either doesn't want to cut right, it cuts too thin, it doesn't want to stick to whatever you're sticking it to, that sort of thing. Like this is especially for adhesive vinyl. So I can actually create an offset. Just a tiny offset. It doesn't have to be anything big. Let's try 0.02. Maybe 0.03. Okay, and just hit apply. And instantly, can you see how that made it thicker? So if I were to, that's the offset. So this is the text. So I can just delete that. And now all of a sudden I have a thicker cut. Now, of course, depending on the font, you can go a little bit thicker and a little bit thicker. But eventually you do run into, especially like if you're talking about like a script font, you'll run into a situation where it does change the, you know, what a font looks like. But for the most part, you can really have a lot of success changing your thicker fonts and still being able to keep the character, the basic look of the font, and just make it a little bit thicker. So definitely very, very useful. I really love doing this anytime I'm having problems cutting a really thin font. Okay, example number three, we're going to talk about just basic designing purposes. Now, what I mean by this is a lot of times you need a situation where you can slice out a layer that is underneath your layer. And you guys can already do this with the slice tool, but sometimes you need to be able to do that with a little bit more division in between. Let me show you what I'm talking about. I'm just going to type out some more text here. Okay, so say I'm creating a design, and for whatever reason, I really need this to fit together. Okay, so I'm just going to leave it right there. And as you can see, they're overlapping. If I was doing this in the same color, I could just weld them together if I wanted to. Or like I said, I could slice out one from the other and get rid of that overlapping area. But sometimes, especially when you're using the same color and you want that division, you do need to be able to do an offset. And let me tell you why. Let's make this a little bit bigger. I just really want y'all to be able to see what's going on. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to create an offset of hello. And I'm going to hit apply. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab that offset. I'm going to hold down shift and I'm going to grab handsome. And that's the part that I'm going to slice. Okay, not the text, but the actual offset. Okay, so let's get rid of the offset altogether. I don't need it anymore. And I can get rid of my sliced areas. Now, do you see what that did? It gave me a division between my letters without it being overlapping. And now I can use the same color if I want, or different colors, but I can use the same color and I can still tell that this is an overlapping area. Now, I'm not going to say that you're going to use this a whole lot, but especially in a situation, I'm just using text here, but you can do this with, you know, different shapes and things like that. You can also do this with knockout designs. That makes it really fun because you will be able to go in and create a little bit more division than you get with just the slice tool. So that's the moral of the story, is you get more division than you would using just the slice tool here. All right, so one of the next things that I have to show you is going to be kind of like a two-part offset. Let's go ahead and go to upload. What I want to do is bring in a piece of clip art that we can play with. And where I'm going with this is you will be able to start creating your own stickers. Now, for whatever reason, this feature has not worked for all the clip art that I've tried to play with. I think there is a little bit of a bug going on. But remember, guys, that the offset is still new, so they're going to be working out a few kinks here and there. So hopefully by the time you need to be able to do this, maybe the offset feature will be working a little smoother. But I just uploaded an image, and I'm going to insert it into my canvas. Now I'm going to mix and match some text with it. So I'm just going to set up my text. Let's go ahead and group our text together. And then I want to line it up with my my little lemon shape here. All right, so let's select all of this and align center. All right, so what I want to do, the first part, is I'm going to create a small offset. And the small offset, let's do like point, what does 0.05 give us? This one, I just want a small offset, and I'm going to fill it in white. So let's find it. There we go. And this is going to help give me a little division between the clip art and my text. All right, so once that's done, let's group that together. And then we're going to create another offset, but this one we're going to do like 0.6, which is actually pretty large for an offset. But this is what's going to give us kind of that sticker look. So the larger the offset, first of all, there's a couple reasons why you'd want to do a larger offset. Because if you're using individual pieces and your offset does not connect, then sometimes it doesn't create the look that you're going for. So what you can do is increase the size of your offset until all of your individual pieces connect, and then you have a little bit more of a cohesive feel to your offset and sometimes to your entire design. All right, so this is where some of the bug comes into play. Can you see how it's not really cohesive all the way around? Unfortunately, I have not found a solid answer for that. What you can do instead, and this isn't the best workaround, but you can actually create like a circle, and you can use it instead of your offset. Now, obviously, that's not going to work for every design you have. Because, I mean, sometimes you don't need a circle or a square. But, I mean, if it'll work, it'll work, you know. At least it works around the text. That was one of the more important parts for me. But I can get that centered. And then let's grab this. So I'm going to hold down my shift key. And then we can weld those together. And if we flatten all that together, I think it is going to give us the desired outcome that we're looking for. See how it looks up here? So definitely here, let's change the canvas color real quick. There we go, there. See what we're talking about? So that way you will have the actual circle around the lemon, and then you'll still have the offset around the ends of your text. So like I said, that is a little bugged out right now, but this is still new. So hopefully that will improve, and then you can just use the offset around the entire print and cut portion to be able to set up your offset, okay? Okay, last but not least, we actually have some really cool text effects that I'm going to show you. So let me just type out some text, and I'm going to change my font again. It's just a bold font. Okay, now this is just your basic offset, just like we talked about earlier. Of course, you can create it to be as thick or as thin as you want. Okay, so that is one look to your text effect. All right, that's what we're going to focus on here. These are your text effects. So I'm going to grab that text, and I'm going to use the same exact text. Actually, as a matter of fact, let's get rid of that. Let's use both of these. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the slice tool. And then I can grab that original text and delete it out. And I'm left with just the outline. Okay, so those have two completely different feels. It probably doesn't seem like it right off the bat, but trust me, absolutely two completely different feels. Okay, and let's do it one more time. So this time I'm going to go ahead and create my offset, but then I'm going to select that offset, and I'm going to create another offset. A lot of times I'll do this, this one a little thinner. What does 0.15 look like? All right, so let's apply that. And now I have two offsets, but bear with me. I want to select both of these offsets. So I hold down the shift I'm using over here on the right-hand side, and I'm going to use the slice. So now I have what is just the outline. All right. So as you can see, I used basically the same set of tools to give me the layered version, the outline version, and this is like a double outline. This is a true outline. This is an outline and the text. So three different ways to use the same tools to get three different text effects. So let's get all these back out here. These are all of the, I won't say these are all the things that you can use offset for. Obviously, offset is a very, very versatile tool. There are a lot of things that you can do with it, but these are, probably five of my favorite, and I would also say the most common ways to use an offset. You can use them for designing, you can use them for thickening up thinner fonts, you can use them for, and I showed this one with a pattern, but you can do that with a solid, but just some really, really cool things that you can do. And hopefully this is a pretty good over for you guys on using your offset, and you were able to learn a few things.
So guys, how did you feel about learning to use all the ins and outs of your offset tool? I know that this is relatively new to a lot of you Cricut Design Space users, so definitely welcome to the Offset Club. It is really neat and it's very powerful. So I'm going to go ahead and wrap it up today, but hopefully you guys learned some things from the video. Of course, make sure you give it a quick like, maybe give it a thumbs up. We always love to hear from you guys, so if you have any questions, leave that down below. But guys, I appreciate you stopping by today, and we will see you again next time.